Hi, good morning, and congratulations to the class of 2015 of Immaculata. I'd like to say, first of all, thank you to the administration of Immaculata for thinking of us here in Sudan and for giving this award. I'm rather humbled by it, but rather quite appreciative also, so thank you for that. My name is Tom Catena, and I'm an American medical missionary, medical doctor and surgeon, and I've been here in the Numa Mountains of Sudan for the past 7 years. People often ask me why I do this kind of work, why would I give up a practice in the U.S. and the life there and come out here to the middle of nowhere to work in this field. And my answer is very simple. Christ gave us a directive to take care of the least of my brothers and sisters, and I've taken those words quite seriously and said, no, let me go ahead and do that, what he's asked me to do. So that's the simple reason why I've come out here. Christ also said, you've got to pick up your cross every day and follow me. And often that's what it feels like here, where there are a lot of challenges and a lot of heavy work. But these words are a great encouragement. We know that Christ suffered himself, and that's all we can do to try to follow him. We know it's also going to entail carrying a cross. So I know now everybody's trying to give you advice and tell you what you should be doing for your future and all this sort of thing. My only small piece of advice would be, whatever job you do, whether it's in corporate America or as a teacher, as a nurse, as a doctor, whatever, take some part of your time to take care of at least of your brothers and sisters in some capacity, whether that's working in a soup kitchen or volunteering or doing as a full-time job or what have you. Take the words of Jesus very seriously, and I think the rewards you'll get out of that will outweigh any sacrifice you have to make. I think one of the problems we have now in the Western world is a lack of fulfillment. People are not fulfilled. They don't feel happy in their lives. There's a certain emptiness, a materialism. I think this is all born out of this idea that material things matter. I would just encourage you to do away with that idea. Remember that people are what matters. Taking care of people is what matters, no matter what job you do. Forget about the material things and pursuing the good life. I promise you, if you try to pursue what Christ is asking of us, you will find the good life. Maybe not with a yacht and a swimming pool and all that sort of thing, but you'll find something much more valuable. So I really would encourage you to follow this line of work. Again, I say congratulations, and I wish you all the best of luck in the future, and God bless you all. Thank you.